romantic imagination and national feelings. Romantic imagination and national feelings. The development of nationalism did not come about through wars and the territorial expansions. That could be one of the reasons which had made the countries to come together, but the culture has played an important role in creating the idea of the nation. Art, poetry, stories help the people to express and shape the nationalistic feelings. So the culture played an important role in creating the idea of a nation. How did the culture play? Culture played an important role by their art forms, the drawings, the paintings, the poetry, what they used to communicate vocally, stories, the historical or legend stories which were told about their leaders or their inspiring personalities. Music, every country has their own special way of expressing themselves. Music which were arranged for marriages, arranged for ceremonies, like that. It has shaped the nationalistic feelings through their art forms, poetry, stories, music, etc. So when we look at romanticism, as a word, romanticism means about the nature. The beauty of the nature is described, that is called romanticism. The culture movement, which is sought out to develop a particular form of national sentiment. Now, you need to bring out the national sentiment among the public. So the romantic artists and the poets generally criticized their viewpoint, that is glorification of reason and science, and focused instead on emotions, institutions, and mystical feelings. They always criticize the reason and science, because through reason and science you don't get the emotional feelings outside. You may be able to understand why the emotions have come after they have come, but in order to generate the sentiments among the public, we need to focus on emotions, we need to focus on the institutional practices which the countries had, and the mystical feeling of belonging to oneness. That can only be developed through the folk songs, folk poetry, folk dances, that the true spirit of the nation. So the romantic imagination and nationalistic feelings are developed, or let us say culture has played a significant role in shaping the nationalistic feelings of the public. How did they shape? Through the art forms, poetry, stories, music, and not the normal music. And the romantic artists always feel that reason and science are important in this century, but from centuries, emotions, institutions, and mystical feelings have driven the public or the humans towards this journey. So it is the folk songs, folk poetry, folk dances, the true spirit of nation. So we have to remember any nation through their folk songs and folk poetry and the traditional way of dancing style, stories, music associated with the culture. So we also have national feelings were kept alive through music and languages. Through their traditional musics and languages, we continue that feeling of nationalism. Karel Karpinský celebrated the national struggles through his operas and music, turning folk dances into polonaise and mazurka into nationalist symbols. So when you take something from the traditional backgrounds, that will be well connected to the public. Language too played an important role in developing the national sentiments. Language itself, when you speak in the regional language or when you speak in the own language, we feel very happy and feel that we all belong to one group, connected. The Russian language was imposed everywhere. Now, why did these people get this feeling? Because the Russian language has been imposed on them, so they want to speak in their own language. So many members of the clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon to show their resistance. So they are saying clear no to the Russian language, and they are resisting it. How they are resisting it? They are not fighting there. They are using their own language, and they are trying to resist the thing which has been imposed against them, that is to speak in Russian language. But we will not speak in Russian language. We will speak in our own language, Polish language. Like that, they were resisting it. As a result, large number of priests and bishops were put in jail and sent to Siberia by the Russian authorities as a punishment for their refusal to preach in Russian language, which means a clear indication that whenever there is a resistance, definitely that will be followed by some step taken by the authoritative people. So here you can see one example. The number of priests and bishops were religious heads. They were asked to communicate in Russian language, but they refused to do so. So they were punished and they were sent to jails. So the notes making points are here: romantic imagination and national feelings, the cultural movement which sought to develop a particular form of national sentiments has been criticized, the glorification of reason and science, but they focused on emotions, intuitions, and mystical feelings. German philosopher John Gottfried Herder tried to discover the culture among the common people. He did a study on this. He went to people, he collected the identities which the common people have about the culture, that is the folk songs, folk poetry, and folk dances. This is the romantic imagination and national feelings. How do we create or make people aware that they all belong to one particular culture? That is through their traditional institutions, mystical feelings, and traditional dances which the common people do in different situations.